Hi.
Hello.
How's everyone today?
We're doing good.
Thank you so much for meeting me.
Of course.
I welcome Scisters Salon to Tuesday with Tammy. I want to introduce Melissa Parker and Easton Basic.
Hi.
Who founded the salon in 2010. If you want, let's see. I was going to say introduce your new, Catherine. If you could say something that you have somebody new here, which is really lovely.
Yes, we do have a new stylist. So her name's Catherine, and she is fabulous.
She is.
And can you tell, we're in La Mesa, California. And what's your website?
It's www.sisters.com. It's spelled S-C-I-S-T-E-R-S.
Very good. We're hiding our smiles today. We're staying safe.
Right.
So, can you please tell our listeners what makes you unique and how long you know each other? A short story, how you went into business together, and what's inspired this?
We met at a salon that we worked at previously. That was probably 15 years ago now. And Easton had said to me one day after we had befriended each other that she said she wanted to go back to school for business. And I said, well, that's really funny. My sister and I are actually taking courses at night. You should come and join us instead of doing it online, as she had said that she wanted to do. So she ended up coming with us, and we took a class on entrepreneurship, one of the assignments was to create a business plan, and we actually really put in a lot of time and energy in doing it, like, for real, like, if we were really going to do it, and at the end of it, we kind of looked at each other like, why don't we do this? We wanted a lot of the same things and cared a lot about a lot of the same things, so that's how we got started.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's a nice story.
Yeah.
Thanks for sharing that. I know one thing that sets you apart is your zero waste and intentional lifestyle shop. And if you could tell our listeners what this means.
Yeah. So I've always been really conscious of the environment, and one of our values is continuous improvement, and so I take that in my personal life pretty seriously, and then as a business, I feel like we have a responsibility to do what is good in the world, because as a business owner, you have a lot of power in the community. And so when I started dabbling into low-waste, zero-waste living at home, which is really, essentially, you're trying to produce as little to or no trash as possible. We were representing and educating for a major hair care brand at the time, and it became increasingly hard on my conscience to continue to sell all the plastic bottles that we were selling, and so we researched and researched on how we could become San Diego's first zero-waste salon. And so we offset any of the things that we can't get away completely from waste. We do have a company that takes it for us and turns it into other items. Like right now, all of our masks are being used to fill roads. So they're turning them into something else. It's one of the things that, like, there are certain things in this industry legally that we can't get away from purchasing that aren't recyclable. And so it's how we change it. Mm-hmm. And then all of our products now are refillable, so.
See? That's fantastic.
Thanks.
That takes extra research, that's for sure.
Yeah.
That's great with the mask. Wow, I didn't know that. I was looking at your website. And love your core values, ambition, connection, service, productivity, and continuous improvement, as you're mentioning. Please take a moment and talk about one of these core values and why it's so important.
Okay, I think continuous improvement, which we have already spoke on, is really kind of the thread that binds us, I believe. We are so passionate about it independently and together, and it has become, I think, kind of the magic of our relationship that we are able to keep going and keep going and keep going and
yeah,
just be better.
I have a hard time picking just one, but there's two that really stand out as far as, like, seeing guests in the salon, and that's service and connection, and I think they go hand in hand in the way that we deliver a service to a customer. It's about connecting with them and making them feel comfortable, whether or not that's talking to them or just making them feel safe here, and then just taking our service level to the next level. And a lot of that is continuous education on what's new, but it also has to do with, like, really listening and delivering the best service possible. So,
mm-hmm. And that you do.
Thanks, Tammy.
Let's tell these wise wisdom how I found your salon. I was visiting my son and daughter in La Mesa and went on a walk. And literally, I walked through the door on my walk and I says, "Do you need a hair model?" And one of you said, let's see. I believe that sort of thing happens in this world. One of you said exactly the same question seconds before I walked through the door. So go ahead and expand. Which one of you said that?
I can't remember exactly. We have, in the first 9 years mm-hmm. of opening our business, we would do a collection, an editorial collection every year where we brought in models, we'd have a theme, we'd shoot them, and I think that was one of our first shoots, and I really wanted, like, long hair, and I wanted a specific person for my model, and it's always hard to find somebody because we like, instead of, like, hiring out models, we really like to find real people. And you just walk through the door and
synchronicity.
Yes.
Right? Meant to be.
Uh-huh.
It was a great photo shoot, and yeah, like you said, I think it was at least 7 years ago, and it was fun. The train, the photographs, green nail polish. I remember the photographer wearing that. So, let's see. How are you dealing with this pandemic of 2020? I know it brings up a lot of hidden fears, and perhaps it showed you what you were needing more, rest and relaxation, perhaps. Re-evaluation. I was listening to what I believe it was Melissa said on your blog for 2020, recreate, tell a short story if you like.
So personally, it affected me in a way that I got to slow down and be quiet and to reimagine what life could be like. And that kind of turned into being able to take care of myself and just quiet. And I believe for the business, we've reimagined the salon completely. We're a completely different salon now than when this started. And the time that we had off, I think it was a total of 4 months-ish, we weren't doing hair, but we were still behind the scenes working on the business, and I think that was the gift in that time to reimagine our business. Is I believe we are really truly authentically shining exactly who we are, and our business has aligned with that, and what we are providing now is higher. It's a higher level.
Yeah, I think with some of the things that we were kind of forced into doing, which is, like before the pandemic, you could find me or Melissa on a Saturday taking 3 clients at a time.
Mm-hmm.
And it was really stacking our schedule. You'd leave at the end of the day and you're wiped mm-hmm. out. physically, and we, you know, we're ambitious, so we're pushing ourselves, and it really forced us to kind of expand, like, our guests are fitting in throughout the week, and we're really only taking one guest at a time, and really having to do that and being forced to has opened our eyes to the fact that, like, you're delivering a much better service when you are focused on that one guest at a time. And it's better for us as mm-hmm. stylists to really have that one-on-one time and to not, like, abuse our body so badly.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I don't think we'll go back to the way things once were.
Take care of yourself.
Yeah.
That's key. I listened to your video and learned about your latest member, Catherine, and I hear she's a blessing and much needed. If you want to tell a short story.
Okay. I mean, we had come to a point where we had decided it's just going to be us. We're going to be a team, and
we had a huge salon team for a while, and filled our chairs, and we had, like, skincare professionals in here, and we even were paying somebody just to run our front desk, and it was a huge team, and slowly that changed. I think a lot of that changed when laws around how we could pay people changed.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think a lot of it changed too when we went zero waste. Mm-hmm. And the salon that people had signed up to work for, we weren't anymore.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so it got to the point where it was just Melissa and I.
Mm-hmm.
And we thought, gosh, we climbed this huge mountain. I felt like I climbed to the top of the mountain. I looked over to the other side and I realized, like, oh, this isn't what I want for myself as a business owner. This is a lot of work to manage all these people. And I don't want to, it left a taste in my mouth that I didn't want to do it anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And then we kind of were fine with that. But much like you walked in, one day Catherine walked in and she just, from the moment that she walked in, I could just tell that she was a gift. And mm-hmm. we had never had a stylist like her before.
Mm-hmm.
And so I couldn't compare
yeah.
what employment would have been like with someone like her. And it mm-hmm. it has definitely opened my eyes. If I said, if there are others of you out there, then bring them on.
Yes.
An added asset for sure. And it's like when somebody walks in the room and they light up the whole room.
Yeah.
You know, you can't even explain that.
Yeah.
I get it. What's your spirit animal? A book you recommend?
Mm-hmm.
It's always funny. Or a saying you like to say?
I got one of each. I think, I love so many animals, but I think what comes up in my dreams and what comes to me often is like a black panther. And so, for some reason, it always emerges itself in my mind. So, I think that's what I'm connected to. And a saying. We have a saying on the wall here, which is one of my favorite quotes by the children's author, Roald Dahl. And it says, if you have beautiful thoughts, they will shine out of your face like sunbeams, and you will always look lovely. And it's from this book, The Twits, and, I mean, the whole book is mean and awful, but there's this one line in the whole book that is just, I love it, so.
That's cute.
I have to say, my spirit animal, I'm a Leo, so I definitely feel the ferociousness of, like, the lion and the protector and the pride and that energy, but I also shift between the lion and then like a honeybee.
Wow, that's sweet too. Very nice, thank you. I see that you have body sugaring. Can you fill our listeners in if you're able to have this service, or we have to wait until you open you know, I guess I want to say properly, but I don't even know what properly is anymore, do I? Is it the simple fact, 100% natural, no colors, no dyes, no perfumes, no parabens, no gluten, no dairy, never tests on animals?
So sugaring is a hair removal alternative to waxing, and it is literally just sugar and water and lemon. And because it's not a resin, it doesn't actually adhere to your skin. It just kind of lays on the top and takes off the hair and then some dead skin cells. So it's a much gentler experience to your skin, and as well as not as painful.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
We found a company, Kiko, she's actually local, and all of her processes and the products that she makes to go with the sugaring process are all zero waste and non-toxic as well. So it aligned really well with our business.
Yeah, keeping it local and mm-hmm. waste-free is and so clean, too, it's mm-hmm. awesome.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. That's awesome. Okay, I see you offer Reiki services. If you can explain, some people don't know, or in the near future, tell our listeners who are not familiar, I am, but there's people who are not, a bit about this and why it's so important and what benefits the client will most likely experience.
Okay. So Reiki is a energy healing. It uses universal energy, which we all have and which is in our environment and in the universe. And it's channeled through the palms of the Reiki healer's hands, and it can be done through touch or really even through just hovering. There's even distance Reiki, so you wouldn't have to, you could be doing some Reiki on someone that's very far away. And the benefits are, there's so many. It can assist and help in healing, if you've had surgery or something, it can work hand in hand with medicine. But also, it's really good for grief and loss and stress and just the energetic body and helping to balance that and heal anxiety or anything like that. People feel many different things and have different experiences. Sometimes you just feel like a warm, relaxed sensation. Sometimes people will get really warm hands from doing Reiki. So if you are using touch, sometimes you'll feel the warmth. And other times it'll like help people to release things emotionally. So sometimes people will cry during a Reiki service if they've had things held inside of their body. Sometimes if I touch somebody in a particular place where maybe that trauma or energy has been held, they will cry. Mm-hmm. And they're most of the time, if they're new to Reiki, they'll be quite surprised at the experience. But for a lot, it's always good. Mm-hmm. It's not anything scary, but... I guess it's clearing things up for people.
And it sounds like when they cry, it could be just a nice release. Like yes. They're releasing things that they've been holding. Yeah. Nice. I see it must be tough for you since one day we can open, then the next day have to close again. Please tell us some words of advice on how you're coping or managing. What works for you, or what has been working for you?
So when we were closed and not able to do hair services, we did keep our apothecary open, and we were doing curbside pickups once a week. We were here on Saturdays, and doing a very safety measure of picking up hair care items. We also did... like root touch-up kits, mm-hmm. customized color for root touch-up kits. And a lot of our a lot of our customers and culture, like the people behind us, really felt the need to support us during that time, which we were super, super grateful for, because it was really, really helpful in that time. But I really kind of took out of it is, I can't control that at all. Mm-hmm. So just work with what I can. Mm-hmm. And like, if we're open, great. This is what we do if we're open. If we're closed, fine. This is what mm-hmm. we do when we're open. And just letting go of trying to really make plans and stick to them, because we had to really be flexible during mm-hmm. that time.
Yeah, that was the biggest thing for me. I think that I let go of anything being for certain this year. Mm-hmm. And that really helped me to cope and manage working and not working and working and not working, and just knowing that I have no control. I really have no control over what's happening this year. I just have control over how I react to it, and making the best with tough situations. And I mean, that's not always easy, and it hasn't been this year, but I think it's the best mm-hmm. we can do mm-hmm. to control our circumstance, you know?
Mm-hmm. Like you said earlier, the positive thoughts.
Yeah.
How we talk to other people, make a smile, right?
Yeah.
Do what you can to have control over. I love your beauty in bulk concept. Talk a bit about this. Talk a bit about the jars as well.
Sure. So the beauty in bulk, when we needed, you know, professional hair care that we could offer zero waste, we looked to some major professional brands, and they weren't willing or weren't ready to go there. And so we had to do the next best thing, which is make it ourselves. So we work with a lab that is in California, and they create all of our products for us. And they send us them in large, big containers. Mm-hmm. And so it helps us. It's what we use on our back bar for our guests, out of the same huge containers. And then we will refill our guests' bottles here. They can either bring in a bottle that they have from home. If they have a plastic shampoo bottle that they want to refill, they can bring it in and we'll put our product in it. We have glass or aluminum available for purchase. And then if they already have a bottle but forgot it, we have a jar library. So we're always accepting jars. We're actually pretty low right now. And so if I had a guest today, she came in, she forgot her shampoo bottles, and I said, well, I can fill these, and then when you get home, you can transfer them. So that's another, and those are free. We just sanitize them, and then they're ready to fill up.
Nice. Hear that? Need some. Well, I thank you, Melissa and Easton, and also Catherine out there, for your beautiful time today, and I really appreciate you.
Thank you.
If you don't mind, I'm going to add your video to my page as well, Tuesday with Tammy.
Yeah.
Thank you again. Any last words?
No, thank you everybody for tuning in and listening, and we hope you guys are all well out there.
Thank you.